I will start 7 songs with these plugins. You can rate the one that you think is the best down in the comments. Hey everyone, quick heads up. MixingKey was awesome and sent me Captain Plugins Epic 7 for free to try it out. Just to be clear, they didn't pay me to make this video. It's all my genuine experience. If you end up loving the plugin as much as I do, please consider buying it. There's a link down in the description. Using that link supports the channel and I'd really appreciate it. Now let's dive into those 7 ideas. Captain Chords allows you to make chord progressions. And then you have a bass that follows those chords. And then you can put Captain Melody and build on top of that. They improved the plugins. It's now easier than before to come up with new ideas. Then you have Roman numerals, different genres where you can select for the chords and the rhythms. And the UI, I think it's more intuitive now. And there are also new sounds from Faceplant. Even if you like what you see, I think I only scratched the surface. I think you can do a lot with these plugins, especially, at least for me, is just to speed up the creation, finding new ideas, finding new chords and new bass and stuff like that. It's something I always struggled, and I think with these plugins you can get started really quickly and then from there add your style to it. And without further ado, let's jump into the songs. Every time I created a new idea, I had to set up Ableton Live. So what I did is I created the template where I have the instruments in one side and then the drums in the other, and then I can put the compressor, and it's all set up so that when I drop the kick, I can then reroute everything and do the side change. I have everything laid out so that when I start Ableton Live, I can just drop Captain Chords and start creating. In this case, I'm going to use Roly Studio, and let's create some synthwave. I started with a very basic chord progression and then I added a rhythm. Then I ended up with these 8th notes at 80% legato, where I noticed that the velocity is different and I used that. But I also moved around with the chords. You can just move this area at the bottom and lay out the chords the way you want. Then I use Captain Deep to add the bass. As you can see, as soon as you drop that, because you already have the chords, it's just automatically syncing with the chords and it plays nicely. Then you can drop the kick. So I went very, very fast. I just wanted to lay everything out. And this is what I like about these plugins, that you can just do things very quickly. It's so fast. Then here I was just playing around with different sounds. I have to mention that Captain Melody is the one that I use the least, so I've been playing around a little bit this time for the video. I found something interesting and then I added a bit of shimmer, some effects. I really like delays. This is what I use, so it may not be what you use, but yeah, there you have it. It's a very simple song. It's not just about the song, if it's good or not, it's just how quickly I could arrive to this. If you get to know the plugins and you get to use them, you can go really fast to the destination. And that's what I like about these plugins. First, let's add a kick and a snare and put them into Captain Beat. Then in Captain Deep, we add 8th notes. Then I adjust the glue compressor so we have this pumping effect. Now let's find a cool instrument for our chords. This is an external instrument, so we need to route it to Captain Chords. It's very easy to do because you can access the tutorial right from the output. In Ableton, you just have to select Captain Chords and Captain Chords twice on the MIDI from, and then just select Monitor In. Now let's select a pre-made chord progression. This is one of the areas that have been improved a lot because now there's these drop downs where you can choose different progressions in Roman numerals. Let's change the instrument. Let's go back to the bass and see if we can change a bit the rhythm. I decided to go back to the chords and add 7th chords and things to spice it up, to make it more interesting. I also added more complexity. This way you have more notes in each chord. It sounds more full. There was some annoying noises on the instrument, so I changed the instrument to this one, but it didn't convince me either, so I also tried to fix it with Q. I don't know. It's just messing around, trying to find the right sound, but this is just me testing, trying to build like a basic song that then it can inspire me to create the full song. So I added this test that I made because I think it's very interesting that sometimes Captain Melody comes up with something, but then you can add a new effect on top of it. Like in this case, I'm adding the delay, and it's adding a new layer to it, and it's making it more interesting. Sometimes it's not just about the melody, the chords, it's a lot about the design, the sound design that you make on top of that. And I think that's how it works a lot of times with electronic music. I went to Captain Deep and added the bass line, and I really like how Captain Deep is very easy to use, especially for this kind of music. Captain Chords has more humanizing options now, but the bass, you have swing and space. For this kind of genre, I don't think it needs that, but I just wanted to show you. I love how the Captain Beat kick fits perfectly this kind of song, so I left it and I just put the glue compressor. Of course, this is kind of simple, but I think this allows me to now go deeper and build the whole song based on this. I love how easy it is to start a new chord progression in Captain Chords. You can even go there and hit the random and you get a chord progression. And from there, you can start tweaking it, like trying to humanize it with swing or adding some space and strum, so it feels more natural. You can also add complexity to get fuller chords, which go very well with piano, like in this instance. I'm using the sound preset by default, I'm not even changing it now. I changed the chords and the rhythm, and then I hopped into Captain Melody. I added an external reverb to the melody. And after that, I started messing around with different presets, and I found this one that I found interesting. the bass was a bit basic, so I went back and changed the sound, and I also tried to find a new rhythm. I spent a fair amount of time trying to find different sounds for the melody or for the arpeggio. But yeah, sometimes that happens. You spend a lot of time trying to find that sound that you like. I then added saturation with the Saturn 2 Pop Filter. It's an amazing plugin for saturation. I really love it. And I think it sounds really different, at least. I don't know if it's good, like I don't know where this song would go, but I think at least it's an interesting sound. And then, because the melody is very simple, I added the second captain melody to see if I could work with two. And yeah, there's no problem with that. It's just that then you have to find the right balance. I don't think I found it, but yeah, I think I like to use Captain Chords, the Captain plugins, to try to find ideas and then create a loop, see if it goes somewhere. If it doesn't, then go and create another. It's so fast, like it takes me like 5 to 10 minutes maybe playing around to find something that sounds nice, and you can iterate or keep working on that song. For this song, instead of dropping Captain plugins, I decided to just add the drum loop that I found. So I opened Captain Chords as usual. I played around with a bit of the chord progressions, and then I moved to the rhythms. I wanted to add more movement, so I ended up pulling the Valhalla delay. I also added Arturia Jupiter. It's a nice synth, it's a emulator or simulator, I don't know. Yeah, I found these strings that was kind of the vibe that I was going for. And I tweak again with the compressor, because I feel that when you use the strings, even synth strings, it's very nice to have that pumping effect with the kick. That relationship needs to work out. I think it's just the way to go. And then I added the bass with deep. I didn't go with the eighth notes that I usually go with. I tried to find interesting bass melodies, so you can see that you can also find those, because in other songs that I made, I usually go with the eighth, because it's what I like for synthwave and styles like that. It's a different kind of song, so that's why I tried to find something cooler. I think this is a nice start for a song that then you can build up to. Let's not waste any more time and let's go to the next one. This is something I've been doing ever since I started using Captain Chords or Captain plugins. Is I come up with a chord progression, but then I use something that creates an arpeggio out of those chords. And in this case, I'm using the Rolly Studio player, but you can do this within Ableton if you want. Check out how, by adding more complexity, I'm adding more notes and then more notes into the arpeggiator. Add a Captain Deep for bass and a Captain Beat for the kick, and you're good to go to get started with your track. So I spent a fair amount of time tweaking and playing around with Captain Melody. I changed the... You see that there's an A and B, A, B. You have different sections. You can make them longer, shorter. There's a lot you can tweak. And then I found this kind of cool melody, but the last note sounded off, and you can just move it around like in the piano roll. It's just a MIDI piano roll. And from there, I just played around with sound design, RC20, stuff like that. But yeah, I was just ready to hop into a new song and create something from scratch again, which is what's nice about this plugin. So you can just start again, boom, get new chords, new bass, new everything. Hey, so I had an issue with the screen recording for this song, so I'm gonna try to explain what I did. So first I dropped this loop, it's a very simple one. And after that, I added these drums manually. I used lo-fi drums that I have from Splice. And then I started with this order. I started with Captain chords first, and I used the piano V2 from Arturia, and I used jazz chords because that works very well for lo-fi kind of vibes and also syncopation. And then I added the Valhalla shimmer to make it lush. And then on Captain Melody, I just made this melody. I don't remember the details. I know I tweaked a lot of things. I did choose a preset, but then I started playing around with the layout, and there's a lot of things you could do, like the directions of the notes. You can also have different sections. I only use 4 bars for these songs, but you can add more bars by pushing this plus button. I used only 4 bars because I just want to come up with ideas very fast, very quickly, and then if I like something that I make, I can then later create the full song with that idea in mind. So for Captain Deep, which is used for bass, I used one plugin, so I used one Captain Deep, but then I created 2 instruments, and then I routed Captain Deep to these 2 instruments. So I have 2 basses. One of these is 1 octave higher. The way I did this is with Ableton Live, you have a MIDI effect that it's a pitch, and then I just added 12 semitones to that pitch, so that means 1 octave, and then I had 2 instruments playing at the same time, and one would play the normal notes and the other would play an octave higher, and that way I created a sub bass and a bass in one go. So yeah, I think it's a very simple song, a very simple idea. It's not that it has like a lot of complex things, but I think it's a good start for a nice lo-fi song. So what I did is I grabbed my guitar. Well, actually it's not a guitar, it's a guitar lele I bought from Thoman. I'll leave a link in the description. I didn't know this, but it's like a ukulele, but you can still play it like a guitar. So I really like how it sounds. And I used it to come up with different melodies, to play around with the loop of the song that I made. And yeah, I think it was interesting. Also, it shows that I haven't played the guitar in a very long time. But yeah, I had fun, which is finally what I like to do when making music, is having fun. And I hope you also have fun, and see you on the next one. Peace.